I'm obviously like still in the same clothes and makeup and hair. So this is gonna be my third vlog on how it is being in a fandom. Cause I know that I can talk a lot, and so I split this up, and I think I'm just gonna split it up into like four sections. So this is gonna be the third video. So in my other two videos, I talked about the positivity and the positiveness of being in the fandom, the ARMY fandom. But now I'm gonna flip it over, and this one actually might be a little bit longer just because I'm talking about the negative things about being in a fandom. Okay, so if you guys didn't know, here we go. And if you guys can relate to some of these, then great, talk to me about it. Okay, so negative things about being in this fandom. Obviously there, when you first enter a fandom, there are people who have already been there, who are probably way more obsessed with, are really obsessed already. And so there are fans who are super duper overprotective over their biases within the group. And then there are fans who are also like super duper protective over the group if it's like their bias group or just in general like the group that they like. But there are fans who are super duper overprotective, and what I mean by that is that like they will be territorial when it comes to their biases and the group. And so let me give you an example. So my bias in BTS is Rap Monster, and an incident I had was like, I have quite a few, I think I had like about like just like 2,500 followers on Twitter, and then I guess I posted up some information about Ratmon, and it was like wrong information. It was basically just like the wrong time, I think, for like a broadcast or something. And this girl, she like DM'd me, and then she was like, you know, like if you're a Rap Monster stan, like, or something, like if you really love BTS and stuff like that, you wouldn't just post information that's wrong about them, you know, cause, and then I was just like, it was a mistake, you know, and I took it down, and you know, I apologized and all that stuff, you know, for people who had been anticipating that, because then when I found out the right information, then I posted that information up. And she was like, well, you know, like, you don't really support BTS that well then if you can't even get the information right. Like, why do you have, like, why are you posting so much information about them and you don't even know it? And then I was like offended, because I was just like, I'm just updating like as fast as I can about what I hear and what I know. If I'm wrong, then I will take it down, and obviously I'll apologize for it. But like, her point was, you have a lot of followers, but yet you're posting up wrong information, which leads these followers to like misinformation. And so for me, I was kind of like, I'm not like an official, like, I'm just a fan account. Like, I'm just a fan too. Like, I'm not going to say that like I am an official fan updater, and I, you know, always get information right. Cause for me, I was like, I am just one person. I'm not a group of like administrators, like admins for a group. I'm just me. It's just me, like Emily, doing this one account. So that's what I brought up to her too, was like, I already apologized for my mistake. I don't feel bad for what I posted up, because obviously we're human and we make mistakes. And three, I'm just a fan account. I had to remind her of that, because she was like going on this spiel like, why are you posting up wrong information, you know, and all that stuff. And I was just kind of like, I'm just a fan account, and I will make mistakes if somebody, like, because sometimes misinformation is like spread around really fast, and so we kind of think like, oh, that could be the right information. And so, like, that was when I just first joined the Fandom too. And so she was kind of like giving me a hard time about that, but I was just like, hey, you know, like, back off, because literally I am, like, in all honesty, I just love BTS. I really love Rap Monster because he's so talented and he's dope, and I'm just a fan account. And so, like, when I told her that, she was just like, well, I'm just saying. And then I was just like, well, don't just say, because, like, literally, I'm not saying I can update you with the fastest information. I'm just saying that, like, if I do find something out, I want everyone to, like, fangirl with me too, you know? And it's kind of selfish to just kind of keep that information to yourself. If you're not sure, then you, like, obviously tweet it as a question, like, is the broadcast at 6 p.m. Korean Standard Time today or not? You know, like, that kind of thing. Anyways, she was giving me a hard time about that. And then I have another story too that's like negative, but that's for another time. So that was just one, and so I guess in a way, like, she was being, I guess what I want to say is territorial over the group and over Rap Monster too, because she said she was a Rap Monster fan too, and she said a lot of stuff too, like, if you love Rap Monster and stuff, like, why do you do this and, like, that, and do that, and whoa, I was just like, whoa, like, Rap Monster doesn't even know I exist, like, he doesn't even care, like, what I'm doing right now, like, you need to just calm yourself, you know. And they were just kind of like, if you were a Rap Monster stan, she was kind of like, if you were a Rap Monster stan, like, you wouldn't be doing this, or like, you would be like this. And I was just like, okay, is there only one way to be a Rap Monster stan? And that's just what really bothered me. And then the misinformation and stuff too. So she was kind of like super territorial, because for her, I know that she is one of the admins for one of the big like BTS accounts, like BTS fan accounts, one of the bigger ones, because there's quite a few, but she is one of the admins too. And I know that she updates people too, and so I guess when she saw me, like, she was just kind of like, why are you updating me with the wrong information, like, you're not worthy of this information or something. And for me, I was like, are you kidding me, oh my gosh, just back off, like, I'm literally a fan account. But that, yeah, see, I told you I was going to talk a lot, but that was just my one experience with, like, how people are super territorial. And also, I think we've noticed this too, like, a lot of people who are not in the fandom, like, when something bad happens to one of the members or to the group as a whole, then people get, like, territorial, and we do get, like, stop talking shit, you know, like, we get defensive when it comes to our group. And I think that goes with everyone too. But, like, for example, just an example, because BTS, they've had like a lot of stuff come up with them. But, like, the issue with the condom and Jin's, like, cooking pictures. And so, like, what happened was, you know, Jin was cooking and he takes pictures of himself cooking and stuff like that. But in the background, there happened to be, like, a condom. And so people were like, oh my gosh, BTS has sex and stuff. And it was so, such a big surprise. And then that, like, set the whole, like, fandom on fire and stuff like that. Because then people were like, oh my gosh, if we thought they were pure, like, they're not even pure. And people were saying all that shit. And I was just kind of like, BTS is human too, like, it's super naive of us to think that they're not having sex. I'm just saying, because they're adults, literally. Maybe not Jungkook. Well, he just turned an adult, but still, you know, it's just, like, stupid stuff like that. Anyways, but, stuff like that just kind of gets the fandom fired up. Yeah. So point two. So, people make up random shit to ruin the group or to get the fandom, like, super mad, and you guys know that too. Like, just the incident, like, which was a big deal, was, like, J-Hope is ugly and all that stuff, and he's useless, and same thing with Jin too, like that he's useless, that he doesn't do anything for the group and stuff like that. Like, people just make up stuff like that so that it can, like, trend worldwide on Twitter and to get the people in the fandom mad. But it's basically, like, it's just stupid stuff. And so that's, like, one of the, like, the most negative things that I hate, because those are like not even facts. Like, it's just people's opinions. And then people, other people in the fandom, like, get fired off of that. And then it just keeps, like, spreading around like wildfire, because then the fandom keeps talking about it, too. And this, what I want to talk about is, like, when I see negative stuff like that, like, I won't talk about it. Because if I don't, because I am a bigger, like, fan account, like, if I talk about it, then people will know. Some people that didn't know about it will know. And then they'll be like, oh my gosh, like, M, what happened? You know? And so I don't want to spread it, you know? And like, that's just me. I don't care if you guys do or anything. But like, for me, I just don't want to spread it. And so like, there's just like so much stuff that has been happening that I would just like not even post my opinion about. Or I'll post my opinion about it like when the fire is done. Then I'll be like, yeah, I agreed with them. And that's it. But yeah, I don't know. There was this one girl though, I don't even know. She was like, what? Like, don't you think that people should be informed though? You know, and I was just like, if it's like a world crisis thing, like we're about to go into a war, sure. But this is like a fandom thing to where people are just saying that J-Hope looks ugly. Like, that's just your personal opinion, you know? And so I'm not gonna go and be like, what? She said that J-Hope looks ugly? You know, like, that's ridiculous. I was gonna say ridiculous and stupid, and I said stupid. Ridiculous. And so I'm like, that's like not even worth your time to be like, be mad about. Or, you know, it's a waste of emotions to just to put all your energy into that and be pissed. Like, just let that go. And so that's what I hate. And then three. So like, there's like, fans at the airport, especially international fans, like, we don't really, like, our excuse, I want to say our, even though I don't do this, but I'm just going to say our, because when you're an international fan, you basically represent the internationalness of your fandom. Basically, like, we don't get to see BTS as much, and so when you do, then, like, you want to touch them and crowd over them when they actually come to your country. And so it's crazy because, like, people, one of the negative things, most negative things, is that people will be, like, super rude just to get the attention of the members. And so some people, like, there's a few videos of, like, people just throwing stuff at the members, like, during the concert, like, a glow stick or like a water bottle or something. Like, they'll try to like throw it so that it'll hit them, so that they'll like turn that way. And it's just like rude. Like, why would you throw something at them? Like, why would you just throw something in general? And then people at the airport like super duper crowd over them, to the point where like they like try not to show that they're scared, but then like really, I'm pretty sure they're like claustrophobic and they are scared that, you know, something could happen to them, because there's like literally 1,000 girls surrounding them. And if you've ever been in like a mosh pit before, it's the worst. Like, you can try to drop all your legs and you will not fall on the floor because everybody's bodies are holding you up. Like, that's just how intense it is, you know? And I think that for them, it's always like that when they go to an international airport, that where the fans are not guarded. And what gets me like mad too sometimes is like, how does the security guards at the airports like not realize how big K-pop is? Because I feel like the fandoms for the K-pops are like the worst fandoms ever. If it's not like One Direction or Justin Bieber or you're out of a know, like one of those two or something, like it's not, people are not going to be like nice. Literally, people are going to be pushing and shoving, and it's crazy. Like, that's just how the fandom is, you know. But yeah, so that's basically all the points I think about the fandom that I really dislike. I have a lot of other like negative fandom stories that I can talk about forever, but I'm not going to. But if you guys have any other things to add to, like, yeah, just comment below.